गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, जस्ट ओपन योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर बुक दैट इज़ मेडिवल यूरोप राइज एंड स्प्रेड ऑफ क्रिश्चियनिटी। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस चैप्टर आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू टेल यू वन थिंग दैट हिस्ट्री डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री ग्रुप्स। वन इज एंशियंट, अनदर वन इज मेडिवल एंड थर्ड वन इज मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री। क्लियर? सो एंशियंट हिस्ट्री, मॉडर्न मेडिवल हिस्ट्री एंड मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द राइज एंड स्प्रेड ऑफ क्रिश्चियनिटी इन मेडिवल यूरोप। So see the medieval age. The term medieval is associated with the middle age. The middle age is a period between ancient and modern time, age of between ancient and modern. So however, the term does not include exactly the same year or centuries in the history in all part of the world. So in Asian Europe, the medieval age extend roughly between 600 to 1500. Clear? So we can say that in India the medieval period is further divided into two part, early and late medieval period. Clear? So periods are given here. So during that time the Eastern Roman Empire was founded, and before he continued for 1,000 years, but Western European Empire was destroyed by the barbarian. Clear? Barbarian tried by the invention of barbarian, Western Roman Empire destroy, and Eastern Roman Empire continue for 1,000 years. Clear? So and Western Europe divided into small kingdoms, and during that time the Gupta Empire was crumbled. Clear? Crumbles means they lose power. So Gupta Empire also lose power, break into break because of the Hun invention. So during that time Prophet Muhammad founded Islam in 7th century AC. So in this early year of 7th century, Prophet Muhammad founded Islam. So please underline when Islam was founded by the Prophet Muhammad in 7th century AC. Clear? Now see the next one. Socio-political system. What type of system was during there? So during the medieval period, during this age, many socio-economic and political changes took place all over the world, like decline of trade and commerce. Clear? And land become most important form of the property. So because of that reason, the socio-economic changes were very marked in Western Europe. The system that developed in the Western Europe in this period and the later in other period of Europe is called feudalism. Feudalism means a system in which peasant receive land and protection from a lord, and work and vouch for him in return. So that system is known as feudalism. So feudalism was there in Western Europe during that time, and mostly social means mostly rural areas, rural life involved in the feudalism. Clear? So the economic life under this system was predominantly rural, and the main division in society was between peasants who work on the land and the feudal lords who either got a share of the peasant produce or had peasant to work on their land. Advent of Christianity. The spread of two important religions during this period had important and far-reaching consequences. They shaped the political, cultural and economic activity of the period. So these religions were Christianity and Islam. So mainly two religions were founded during that time. So Christianity was founded by Jesus Christ, and his followers are called Christians. Now we will learn about the Jesus Christ. He was born in Bethlehem, a small village of Jerusalem. His father Joseph and mother Mary were Jews. Jesus was born in about 4 BCE. It is said that an angel visited Mary, the mother of Jesus, before his birth and told her she was blessed and her son would be blessed too. Jesus spent his early life as a carpenter, but at the age of 30 he went about preaching his message. He spoke in a simple language and soon had a large following. He also came to be known as a great healer. Here, healer means who cure the people. His simple life, magnetic personality, and outstanding love and compassion, Jesus are all drew large number of people around him. Jesus emphasized on one God and gave immense importance to love, brotherhood, and compassion. He fearlessly criticized all harmful activities and evils. This made the rich and powerful among the Roman his enemy. They complained to Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor of Palestine, accusing Jesus of calling himself the kings of Jews, and thus encouraging people to rebel against Roman ruler. Jesus was arrested and crucified. Crucified means killed by fastening to a cross. So he was crucified, and the cross became a sacred symbol of the Christians. The Christian believed that Jesus Christ rose from the dead on the third day after the crucifixion. This is known as the recursion of Easter, and Easter is celebrated every year in memory of this event. Good Friday is a day on which Jesus is believed to have been crucified. Christmas celebrates the birth of Christ. Christians believe that Jesus was the Son of God who died a painful death on the cross to save mankind from sin. So he is a person who sacrificed his life for the mankind from sin, to save mankind from sin. The holy book of the Christian is the Bible. It is divided into two parts. The Old Testament tells the history of Jews and their relationship with God, and New Testament, which contains the life of Christ and his teaching. Now, teaching of Jesus. First, God is one, so worship of several gods is no avail. Christ called God just and benevolent. Benevolent means kind, generous. One must love him, and he loves all his people. Sinners can always repent and be saved by God. We should hate the sin and not the sinners. Next is sympathy and compassion for fellow being is an important teaching of Christ. The New Testament comprising the four Gospels written by Matthew, Mark, Luke and John. So four are there. Jesus chose 12 disciples to help him in his mission of spreading love and compassion. Clear? He preached that people must show compassion to the poor, feed the hungry and sick, and give shelter to the homeless person. So these were the teaching of Jesus. Now, how it spread of Christianity. After the death of Jesus, his follower, his disciples, Peter, Paul and John, Peter, Paul and John jealously spread Christianity in the Roman Empire. The Roman ruler left threatened by the spread of Christianity. So in the beginning, Christians were hated and persecuted by Romans and Roman emperors. So they were regarded as danger, disloyal and unpatriotic. When a great fire broke out in Rome during the reign of Nero in CE 62, he held the Christians responsible for it. So he killed Saint Paul and persecuted Christians ruthlessly, burning them alive and throwing them to wild animals in the amphitheater. Thousands of Christians were also tortured during the reign of Marcus Aurelius Diocletian. So it removed the Christians from army and public offices, burned Christian churches and refused to fire Christian slaves. Role of Emperor Constantine. Gradually this religion became popular. Clear? Slowly it became popular, and under the influence of Theodosius I, Christianity became the only religion recognized by the state. So slowly but steadily, Christianity spread throughout the Roman Empire, which included most of the modern Europe countries. So mostly which cover the modern Europe country, in that area Christianity spread. Clear? By the efforts of Theodosius I. Okay? Next is Emperor Constantine established Christianity. He introduced laws supporting Christian moral teaching. He also started the custom of observing Sunday as a Christian holiday. Clear? So he started Sunday as a Christian holiday. So in the next 200 to 300 years, Christianity spread throughout Europe. Next, Christ disciple Saint Paul. He was a person who, this disciple, carried Christ's teaching to various countries like Greece and Rome. Roman Emperor Constantine I embraced Christianity in CE 313, and it became the official religion of the Roman Empire by the end of the 4th century CE. The Christian church became very well organized. The Bishop of St. Peter Church in Rome came to be considered as a representative of Christ on earth. So people called him Pope. Clear? So slowly and steadily the Christianity spread in all over the Europe. क्लियर। डिक्लाइन ऑफ एंशियंट रोमन एम्पायर। सो स्लोली स्लोली दिस रोमन एंशियंट रोमन एम्पायर वॉज डिक्लाइंड बिकॉज ऑफ सम ऑफ द रीजन। सो मेजर कॉजेज फॉर द फॉल ऑफ द रोमन एम्पायर वर पोलिटिकल करप्शन, कॉन्स्टेंट वार, फाइटिंग अमंग सोल्जर्स, स्लेव रिवोल्ट लाइक दैट। सो दीज वर द रीजन्स विच रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द डिक्लाइन ऑफ रोमन एम्पायर। सो इम्पेरियलिज्म डिस्ट्रॉय डेमोक्रेसी, इनकरेज स्लेवरी, क्रिएटेड आइडल सिटी मॉब, पोलिटिकल कन्फ्लिक्ट एंड करप्शन। सो स्लोली स्लोली और बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दीज रीजन्स लाइक करप्शन अमंग द पीपल्स, अमंग द सोल्जर्स एंड फाइटिंग अमंग द सोल्जर्स, ठीक है, एंड स्लेव, दीज ऑल रीजन्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द डिक्लाइन। सो इन एग्रीकल्चर इन और इंडस्ट्री कुड थ्राइव ऑन स्लेव लेबर, सो स्लेव रिवोल्ट बिकम फ्रीक्वेंट। सो नेक्स्ट इज द वेस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ रोमन एम्पायर वॉज डिस्ट्रॉय बाय द बारबेरियन इन्वेजन एज वी अर्लियर नो डैट, एंड द ईस्टर्न रोमन एम्पायर और बेजेंटाइन एम्पायर, ईस्टर्न रोमन एम्पायर ऑल्सो नोन एज बेजेंटाइन एम्पायर बिकॉज ऑफ द कैपिटल बेजेंटाइन विच वॉज बिल्ट बाय द कॉन्स्टेंटाइन पोल, एम्पायर कॉन्स्टेंटाइन पोल एज इट कैपिटल। सो वैन द टू कॉन्कर द बेजेंटाइन टेरिटरी इट डिक्लाइन। The coming of Christian religion to Rome play a part in weakening the role of emperor of a slave state. So Christianity with a deal of equality and love had great appeal for Rome oppressed people. So great was its attraction that believers were willing to endure persecution by the emperor. Clear? The final blow to the Roman Empire came at the hand of northern invaders. So they were German tribes like Goths, Franks and Vandals. So these were the German tribes, and these tribes were referred to as a barbarian tribes. So when they these barbarian tribes they had long been marking raid on Roman outposts and on the city of Rome itself. Finally, because of the Vandals, they overthrew the emperor who ruled the Western Empire, and their chieftain established himself as a king. So by this the Roman Empire declined. Next is what was the impact of the decline. So the downfall of a Roman Empire resulted in great confusion in Western Europe, giving rise to large number of small cities. So large number of small cities arise, clear. Then Charlemagne founded an empire which included modern France and Germany. So one new territory was formed by the Charlemagne. Next is the Holy Roman Empire came into existence and extended over Germany and Austria. So gradually many big and small kingdoms grew up because of the decline of vast Roman Empire. So the fall of Roman Empire had an adverse impact on Latin learning also. The spread of Latin language was halted and the use of language itself declined. So Latin language also declined because of the decline of Roman Empire. Yeah. Next is Byzantine Empire. So as we earlier read that Vandals overthrew the emperor. So Vandals invaded and plundered the city of Rome, and then in CE 476 the last Roman emperor Romulus Augustus the last Roman emperor was deposed. So after this there was no emperor in the west, so only a remnant of the Roman Empire survived in the east with its capital at Constantinople. Clear? So this Roman Empire was captured by the invader Vandals. Clear? So next is emergence of Turk. The fall of Constantinople and the capture of the capital of Byzantine Empire by an invading army of Ottoman Turk in 1453 sent a shock wave in Europe. The name of Constantinople was changed to Istanbul, present Istanbul. The capture of Constantinople marked the end of Roman Empire and the beginning of Ottoman Empire. So the Ottoman dynasty is named after the first ruler of the Ottoman polity, Osman I, who descended from a Turkish tribe which had migrated from Central Asia in the wave of Mongol conquest. So after the Mongol conquest, this learn about the Crusade War. The Crusade were a series of religious war between Muslim and Christian between the 11th and 13th centuries. So war between Muslims and Christian known as Crusade War. So eight crusades were fought spanning a period of 2 centuries. The aim of the Christians was to capture the Holy Land of Jerusalem. That was the main aim of the Christians from the Turks, because now Turkish tribe was got the power. So the main aim of the Christians were to capture the power from the Turks. So Jerusalem, the Holy Land of Palestine, was conquered by the Arabs in CE 638, but according to Christian, it was a place of Jesus crucifixion and resurrection. So in the first crusade, Christian soldiers from France and Italy captured Antioch in Syria and claimed Jerusalem. Many Muslims and Jews were killed. The Christian quickly established 4 crusade states in the region of Syria, Palestine. Later crusades were directly at their defense and expansion. So crusade war was their war between the Muslims and the Christians. So Christians wanted the Holy Land of Palestine because that land was belonged to the Jesus crucifixion. So after that, Salahuddin created an Acto-Syrian empire and gave the call or jihad or holy war against the Christian and defeated them in CE 1187. Clear? So we can say that the first crusade was done by the Christian soldiers from France and Italy for capturing Antioch in Syria and claim Jerusalem. Then after that, Turk captured Edessa, and an appeal was made by the Pope for a second crusade war. Clear? And in that war, German and France army again made an attempt to capture Damascus, but they were defeated. Then after that, jihad, holy war was against the Christian, and they defeated them in CE 1187, and they regained Jerusalem. Clear? So the loss of the city prompted third crusade in CE 1189, but the crusade gained little except from some coastal town in Palestine and free access to Jerusalem for Christian pilgrims. Clear? So crusade had a profound impact on Europe, its life, culture, society and economy. Now we will learn about the impact of this crusade holy war. The first is, the crusade came in contact with the advanced Arab and Greek civilization and gained knowledge in spheres like science, in the field of science related to mathematics, algebra, art, architecture. So these type of knowledge gained by them. Second, the crusade learned the use of gunpowder and guns from the Turks. That is the next main impact. After that, trade relations between Europe and Asia also grew up because of this war. Trade relation also grew up. New trade routes were explored. Then the king received more revenue from the trader in the form of taxes. Monasteries and their significance. This is the last topic of this chapter. So an important development in this period was the building of monasteries. Monasteries means universities. Place for giving education. So monastery is an institution where monks live and they give knowledge related to their religion. So monks were men who lived and worked for the welfare of the human race and devoted their life to prayers. So that were monks. So monks lived during that time in a monastery, who is an institution. At the end of 4 centuries CE, many devout and well-do Christians at Rome decided to become monks and go to Palestine. So they were tired of luxury and corruption in the Western world. They helped the poor and aided the pilgrim to visit the holy places. So monasteries played a very important role during the Middle Ages. They helped people to get out of disorder left in Europe. So after the fall of Roman Empire, there were anarchy. Anarchy means a situation in which people do not follow rules and regulations. So there was an environment of anarchy and ignorance in Europe at that time. And monasteries were the only center who give order, discipline and learning. Clear? So the monk clear the land. They develop the art of animal husbandry as well as the skill of craftsmen, different type of works given by them. The art of stained glass painting, wood cutting, these type of work also given by the monks. Clear? So they provided different type of knowledge. So monasteries had great influence on the people of Europe. They were a center of learning. Both religious and secular education was imparted in these monasteries. And the monasteries provided missionaries to preach in torn Christian land also. They also led, monasteries also led in church reforms. So in that, monks who preach different type of teaching, different type of learning, they was considered an ideal monks. Clear? So by the 16th century, the Christian church had many divisions. The mostly the church divided into two parts, Catholic church and Protestant church. Clear? So the success of monastery, their wealth and power ultimately led to their downfall with the beginning of Renaissance and Reformation. Clear? So hope whole chapter understood by you. One timeline is given in your book. Just try to learn all the events, whatever written in this timeline, which was happened during different years that come in your paper. Thank you.